Let me ask you a question. Do you know what a placebo is? Now let's say you go to the doctor because you don't feel so well, but the doctor comes back and tells you there's nothing wrong with you. But you insist, you feel like, nah, there's something wrong with me. So doctors can probably give you placebo. What is that? It's sugar. It's fake medication to make you feel like you're feeling better. What the hell am I talking about? Now let's use the term placebo template. Now I'm not against using templates by far, but I am against using placebo templates. What is that? How do you even know if you have a placebo template? Check the content. How much of the content are you actually writing by yourself? If you are required to write more than 50% of the content by yourself and the other half is provided by the template, that's a placebo template. If you have to write that much content by yourself, you might as well write the whole thing by yourself. My name is Sonny and this is Sonny English. And in this channel, I provide real tips and tricks on how to get your PTE score. If you're new here, please subscribe. In this video, I'm gonna share one of my lessons from my previous classes where I taught how to write the summarized spoken text without using templates. Now, most of my students now, they all use templates because I don't provide placebo templates. Now, if you're already writing the content by yourself or most of it at least, why don't you just write it all? And this video will show you how. Why use something that's only gonna get you halfway there? Because there ain't no such thing as halfway crooks. Y'all ready? Let's get into this. For the summarized spoken text, most people have been using templates. In case you feel like you don't want to use a template, you wanna test yourself and you want to write this thing by yourself, I will show you how I would do it, how we have done it before, but we don't use this technique anymore. But it's the same thing. We're not going to write down the content itself. I'll show you what we write down. It's the same. I'll play the lecture for you and you listen for the nouns. And I'm going to take a variation. Let's not take down the same amount of nouns, okay? Just give me three. Each person just give me three and I'll show you why, okay? Just give me three nouns each person because I'm going to mix the content together. So we'll all participate. We're all going to do this together. And I'll show you how to do the summarized spoken text. The number one rule right now is content doesn't matter. You already know that by the garbage that we just wrote, right? Literally, we wrote the word garbage too, right? So yeah, content doesn't matter when I show you this technique. And all we care about is writing complete sentences. And we will use simple sentences the way I introduced it last time, all right? So I'll play this lecture for you. Don't worry about writing that many words down. Just give me three nouns and that'll be enough. All right.
In-ear phones are a popular tool for listening to audio on MP3 players, mobile phones, etc. But reports suggest that if they are not used correctly, they can damage our hearing. Could you explain a bit more about that?
Certainly. Did you know that the maximum volume of an MP3 player is 10 times louder than the level recommended by doctors? Now, most of us don't use maximum volume. In fact, we tend to listen at a sensible level when we're in a quiet place such as at home. The problem is when we're somewhere with a lot of background noise, like a train or a bus. One study suggests that 80% of us listen at dangerous levels in this situation. Unfortunately, hearing problems don't appear for several years, so most people continue to listen at a dangerous volume until it's too late. We, therefore, need to do more to educate people about how to use in-ear phones so they can enjoy their music and protect their hearing at the same time.
Very good. So we got MP3 players. MP3 players will be all capital, okay? So I'm pretty sure it stands for something. I just don't know what it is. MP3 players, sorry. Doctors. Trains, but we got phones, yeah, just random nouns, so we're taking down reports, all right, volume, buses, so you see the words are starting to repeat, that's okay, mobile phones, volume, doctors, music cannot be counted, okay, music is not a countable noun, music, songs can be counted, but, oh, okay, there you go, background. We have
audio problems. I'll just stop here. I'll stop after this one. Situation. Done. So normally you would probably just write down something like this, or maybe not as many. Okay, so what are we gonna do here? We want to create simple sentences. Remember how we practice it? We have the subject, verb, object, and then we throw in some adjectives, some prepositions, some adverbs, just to build a independent. We want to build an independent, simple sentence. All right, so that's what I'm gonna do for you first. And then I'll ask you guys to do the same thing for me. I'll just pick the first two words randomly. Well, I guess it's not random. I just picked the first two words. I picked the first two words and I'm gonna make a simple sentence with this. And I don't really give a damn what the lecture was talking about. All right, I'm gonna make my sentence based on these two words.
Doctors are informing patients to stay away from MP3 players.
That's not true, but whatever. Okay. Yeah, recommend would be fine too. So, doctors are informing patients to stay away from MP3 players. And here's, I use a continuous tense. Right now, it means right now, right? So we have our subject, we have our verb, we have our object right here. Here's the preposition, but I gave an infinitive to stay away. Okay, so I gave the infinitive and then a preposition and then a noun. So pick any two words that you want and create a simple sentence like that for me. Independent, no pronouns. Don't use any pronouns. It's a standalone sentence. So I don't know why this is bold, but I'll take off the bold. And I'll pick six sentences that I feel are complete. I'll fix whatever you write if you make a mistake. This way I get to see your writing as well. So yes, create a pick any of these two words from here and then create a simple sentence for me. Just one. All right, give it a shot. Now, playing loud audios can cause serious problems to ears and can worsen the situation. Complete, done. Here, the loud volume can be dangerous for the ears. Done. Okay. Can be dangerous for the ears. How dangerous? Let's put it an adverb. Let's put it an adverb for this. How dangerous? Because I don't see any adverbs here. Extremely dangerous. There you go. Okay. Well done. There you go. We want to. There you go. Good work. Done, done, done. So many reports recommend decrease the volume when we use earphones. Okay. That's done. Trains are full of people talking on their phones, okay? Let's do adverb again. How are they talking? Loudly.
Done. Beautiful job. I was thinking the exact same words.
Loudly talking on their phones. All right, here. MP3 players should only be used as background noise, okay? This is now done. Okay, so let's continuously talking. Yeah, you can say continuously as well. Okay, so MP3 players. There you go. We have six sentences, right? We just randomly wrote down six sentences based on the vocabulary words that we have. Now, if you see this right here, if you remember from the tutorials, we have a tutorial on linking sentences together. And we create a complex compound sentence that way. Let's create the complex. Where do you see two nouns that are repeated? Do you see any nouns that are the same? And which two sentences? MP3 player, very good. I'm gonna take that. This is the first sentence. I'm gonna put it down here. And this is the second sentence, the last sentence, sorry. And I'm gonna take that and put it down here. So, let's make it this way. MP3 player, they're both the same nouns. This one's easy to link because one is at the end, one is at the beginning. So, MP3 players, is this a person, place, or a thing? It's a thing. So, we will make this into which. Thank you very much. And where do we put it? Where do I place this sentence? Remove the full stop. That's it. Well done. That's done. The sentence is done. Doctors are informing patients to stay away from MP3 players, which should only be used as background noise. We put which after what we want which to be, which actually is MP3 players. So we got to put it right after that. Okay, this sentence is done. So now we want to use the compound. So it doesn't really matter which one we want. Content doesn't matter. So give me one of those conjunctive adverbs. Which one do you want to put here? Therefore. Okay? And let's just go grab a sentence. Furthermore will be fine as well. So look, I'm going to take this sentence. I'm going to put it here. And I'm going to change that P to small p. Therefore, playing loud audios can cause serious problems to ears and can worsen the situation. That kind of makes sense. Doesn't really have to, but it did. Now, the rest, we're done. Just copy, paste. Well, I'm cutting and paste. Okay? Cutting and paste it. Take it and put it here. Take it and put it here. There you go. There's your six sentences. We created a complex compound sentence in the beginning. It doesn't matter where it goes, unless as long as you create it. Oops, what am I doing? I was talking about the spaces and I didn't create that. There's our summary. Hopefully we're not referring back to the lecture itself. We just made this up. Everybody wrote their own sentence and we put it together. The loud volume can be extremely dangerous for the ears. Many reports recommended decreasing the volume when we use earphones. Trains are full of people talking loudly on their phones. There you go. The last one kind of didn't make sense, but it doesn't matter. You already know we won't make sense because we wrote something earlier that didn't make no sense, right? How many words do we need? We have 63. So sometimes we don't even need that last sentence. What happens if we take away this last sentence? There you go. 50 to 70. 63, we're perfect. Right? 50 to 70. If we take away that last sentence, we're still at 53. There you go. Okay? So if you felt like, oh, that last sentence didn't make no sense, take it away. You still have enough words. If you put it there, you leave it there, it doesn't even matter. You have 63 words right in the middle. Okay, we were not worried about word count. We're just writing about six sentences using some of the nouns that we took down. And we just created simple sentences with no pronouns because it's hard to find the links with pronouns if you write it that way. So we just write independent, simple sentences.
All right, there you have it. Thank you for watching. Once again, this is one of my older techniques. We don't really use it as much anymore. Most of us just use templates, real templates, not placebo templates. But if you feel like you're capable of writing simple sentences on your own, feel free to use this. Please check out my other tutorials. Don't forget to drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you on the next one.